I'm going to do some linear regression using R with Qwerty. We're going to pull data out of the database that we've worked with before. So we're just going to try to perform linear regression based on the budget and team size of a project. Okay, let's start by pulling the data out into a table so we can get a feel for it. So if we just get one of these queries from the other day. Perform linear regression to predict the success rate of a project based on its budget and team size. I'm not sure how we're going to predict the success rate of the project, but we can at least do linear regression on the budget and the team size. I don't fully understand that statement in the spec that we were given. So I'm going to do the next best thing. So if we take a look at our SQLite database, we have projects, and then they have a budget. We also have project developers, which have the list of developers that work on a project. So we're going to get the project developers, link the developers and the projects, count the developers per project, and put them up against the budget, I think. That's the plan anyway. Let's see how this goes. Do we have a query that's closer to what we need? I think this might be fairly close to what we want. Select I think in this case we want to select the project IDs. Okay, let's select star from now. From project developers, join on projects and developers. Successful this might be needed if we want to consider it a successful project. We'll see. For now, let's leave it out. Group by project IDs. We don't want to limit or change anything there. I don't think we want to order anything either. We don't need to. So if we pull out our linear regression, we get the project. Gonna budget, and then we're gonna account. The developer IDs. What am I doing wrong? Select budget. That's going to make for a sucky linear regression model. Do we have this query anywhere close to correct? So we have four projects. Should I be joining in the assets too? So let's forget the project name. And this makes sense because the developers haven't been assigned to other projects yet. Performed in, to predict the success rate of a project based on the says team size. So that implies asset developers too, I think. Select project, budget, and count by developer ID. From asset developers, join developers on developer ID. then we want to join assets on asset ID and then join projects on project ID. So we join this on the subquery. Let's remove this for now. It's going to complain about a lack of budget and project name. Should have known. So we want to join the project and developer. Okay, so we can, oh, this is going to be insanity. Turn project developers on develop. And then the joint project on that. Does that even give us anything? Gives us something. Even less. Okay. Okay, so if we join by everything, even that when things don't exist, we will, in theory, get all of the developers associated with a project. What the heck is this? And then do we want to full join? Assets on project. Okay, I think I need to start from the start. Star. Select start from projects. And then join project developers on project developer project ID. Let's start here. Cool. So now we see all of the projects. With all of the IDs. Or the developers responsible for them. We also want to join all of the assets developers onto this. So we can join assets on the project ID. So do a full join on assets. Assets project ID matches project ID. So that gives us project name, the developer ID associated with them, and then the asset associated with them. This is turning a bit mental. Perform linear regression to predict the success rate of a project based on its budget and team size. Maybe I need subqueries for this. Maybe I need to. So this gives me the developers working on projects. I don't want a full join. I just want the standard one. So cool. And from this, I only really want project ID. Okay, let's make multiple queries. Project ID. And account. Budget and account of developer ID. And then this is done by grouping the developers into one. So we want to aggregate by the developers. Does this work? In projects, join project developers on project developer project ID. That's definitely not correct anyway. They give us project ID. Okay, so that brings us back to where we started. It gets us all of the developers on the project. Now we need to get all of the asset developers associated with the project. How the heck do we make sure they're unique? I guess we don't yet. Okay, so we'll have a second query that does the same for asset developers. Assets developers. So this gives us all of the developers associated with that. And then that has an asset ID and a project ID. And assets have a project ID. So we're going to get from assets. Join asset developers on. Join asset developers on. Join asset developers. Select project, project ID. Budget from assets. Join asset developers on the asset project. Oh god. Maybe this isn't the biggest worry of mine. Maybe I should just be performing linear regression on this first one. Team size implies the whole team, which is all the asset developers and the project developers working on a project. So I need to get all of the asset developers and I need to get all of the project developers associated with a project ID. Then count the distinct developer IDs across all of the projects and get the budget. So I want two subqueries that give me the project ID and the developer ID. This is nonsense. Okay, let's do this first. So if I want to get the developers on a project that worked on specific assets, how do I do this? So asset developers has asset ID. So I can join that to an asset. So this gets me all of the developer IDs for an asset, technically, minus the 200 index. I don't want to group this by anything. Yes. I still need to link the projects to this. So an asset has a project ID. So I can join projects to assets, like so. Project ID. And then on the project ID against the asset ID for the project. So each asset has multiple projects associated with it. And then by connecting this, we get the developer ID. So now we can count the developer IDs that we see per asset. Why would I do that? Brains off for the day. Okay. So what? One entry each. Select. Ah, it's because I'm counting the developers too early for that. So on this project, on project 101, we have one developer. I think it's a one-to-one relationship. Yeah. What if I... Ah, we have two 14 works on two different projects and also doesn't work on any of the assets. So now if we look at three, or project 102, we can see that multiple people have worked on this project that will not have worked on this here. So now what we have to do is we have to prefix this with 200 because God knows why that doesn't happen. I think this doesn't outright work. Cool. So now 203 or 201 works and 201. So we can see 201 has worked on two different projects in different capacities. Cool. Getting closer. We have the project ID, we have the budget, and then we have the developer ID. So now we need to create a subquery. Select star from join. How do I join two subqueries? then join the other query. Project developers on and then this is going to be project developers. So select, no, that's the wrong way around. And then if we run this, we should hopefully see a table that has all of them. So 214. That's not what I want to do, is it? Union? Is that what we want? So if I go 214 now, we can see 214 has worked on three projects, which is still the same. And then if we Take 201, which I think was in both of them. We can see that 201 now shows up in this second list, which is perfect. It's exactly what we want. And now we need to find a way to count these developer IDs across the two queries. So we have a union of the two data sets. So I think at this point, we're going to want all of these. Count. I need to double check the precedence of this. So this is our entire from query. And then we can do subquery developer IDs so we can count them. That way we aggregate the result. Let's remove distinct for now. Actually, no, missing bracket. Oh, okay, so it's something like this instead. No. Well, for now, let's just count this anyway. remove this and remove this. Does this still work? Yes, it does. So it just counts all of them. It's not going to work, is it? No. All right, I'm going to come back to this after some food, and then hopefully I'll have a solution for this query issue I'm seeing too. Thank you. Bye.